Hello and welcome everyone to this session on images in toxicology. My name is Dr. Janvi and I am the anesthesia educator on An Academy. Today we are going to be discussing some quick images in toxicology, different types of snakes, poisons, how do you identify them, what are the basic questions asked on them. It will be a quick class and we are going to be doing all the high yield images which have been asked previously in all the exams, NEET, PG, FMG. So let's begin with our class for today. The plus subscription on An Academy will help you get access to both live and recorded classes. You can learn from India's top educators, you can compete in live tests and quizzes, you can study on the device of your choice, and you can access our question bank with 25,000 plus questions. If you buy the 12-month and above subscription, you will also get printed notes of our classes. The Iconic subscription is a partnership between An Academy and PrepLadder. So you will get the live classes of An Academy along with the video lectures of PrepLadder and the question bank of PrepLadder. Then we have the NEET PG Combat Test on the 10th of October at 11 a.m. As you can see, the first 200 ranks can get a highly discounted An Academy subscription. In fact, rank 1 to 3 will get a free 1-year NEET PG subscription. In our special classes, we have the raise a hand option. So here the learners can speak to their favorite educator live during the class and clear their doubts. We have a limited time offer going on the NEET PG subscription, as you can see over here. So we have the 12-month subscription for 38,250 rupees. We have the 18-month subscription for 42,750 rupees. Then we have the free INICET grand test on the 26th of September. And we have some special class features in which we have interactive live classes, polls, raise a hand option, and you get the PDF of the lecture notes at the end. Then we have our question bank with 25,000 plus high yield clinical questions. And these are a few of our star learners. These are the batches which are on right now. We have the target NEET PG 2022 batch and the mission INICET 2021 batch. Along with that, we also have the Focus FMG batch for FMG 2021 and the Clinical Examinations and Procedures batch. These are a few of our subscriptions and the offers with them. If you buy a 24-month subscription, you get 4 months free. If you buy a 12-month subscription, you get 2 months free. And if you would like to get an offer on your NEET PG subscription, you can use my code Dr. Janvi Life, which will help you get 10% off on your subscription. So let's begin with our class for today. This is the first snake that I want you guys to identify, and also tell me what kind of poison is produced by this snake. So if you see, this is the hood of the snake, it has fangs, and whenever you want to identify a snake, you should try to look at the scales. So the scales in this case, as you can see, are brownish black in color. Okay, now if you look at the head of the snake, you will see that there is this eye-shaped pattern present over here. So when two eye-shaped pattern is present, it is called as a binocillate snake. Anyone, can you identify the snake for me? Yes, so sometimes you have a single eye-shaped pattern present like this, so that would be called as a monocillate snake. Okay, so this snake, as we can see over here, is the cobra. Okay, so cobra is also called as Naja Naja. Now can you tell me what kind of venom does it produce? Is it vasculotoxic venom, neurotoxic venom, or myotoxic venom? What kind of venom is produced by the cobra? You can write your answers in the chat box and I will be able to see it. Absolutely correct. So the venom produced by cobra is neurotoxic in nature. Okay. Now this is our next snake over here. So again, look at the scales and the color and try to identify the snake. So identify the snake. What is the other name or the scientific name of the snake? And you also have to tell me what is the identification feature. And the last thing that I want you guys to tell me is what type of venom is there in the snake? Okay, absolutely correct. This is the common crate snake. The other name for common crate is Bungarus caeruleus. Okay, Bungarus caeruleus. How do you identify the snake? It has slate blue or black color with white transverse markings on it. Okay, so white oblique or transverse markings on it. And what kind of venom does it have? It has a neurotoxic venom. Alright. Now, the next snake that we have over here is this. So, identify the snake. What is the typical identification feature of this snake? What is the scientific name? And how is the venom? Okay, answer all this. In this one PPT, you will be able to complete all the questions about snakes and toxins in FMT. So you can see the snake has bands on it, alternate yellow and black bands. This looks like a taxi, yellow and black taxi. Okay, so this is called as a banded crate. What is the scientific name of a banded crate? It is Bungarus fasciatus. Bungarus fasciatus. Okay. How do you identify the snake from the taxi scales? Just remember alternate yellow and black taxi scales. And how is the venom? The venom is neurotoxic in nature. Okay. All right. Now, next, let's identify the snake. So, identify the snake. What is the typical identification feature? How is the venom of the snake? Batao. Okay. If you see the snake, if you see the top of his head, he will have this typical arrow shape over here. Okay. So, this is one of the very characteristic features of this snake. So the name of this snake is saw-scaled viper. What is the typical identification feature? It has brown diamond-shaped scales. So if you see over here, all these scales, they have brown diamond-shaped scales. Along with that, if you look at the venom of the snake is vasculotoxic, okay? So the venom is vasculotoxic in nature. So the first three snakes that we saw, it had neurotoxic venom, but this snake will have vasculotoxic venom in it, okay? All right, next. Identify the snake. What is the typical identification feature? What is the venom of this snake like? And what is the scientific name of this snake? Okay, answer this. I'll be back in a second. I'll just put the charger to the laptop. Okay, if you look at the snake, the name of the snake is Russell viper. Okay, and the scientific name is ulta of this. Russell viper ka ulta, just switch the words, it is Vipera russelli. Okay, रसल वाइपर का उल्टा इज वाइपेरा रसली. सो दिस इज द साइंटिफिक नेम. हाउ डू यू आइडेंटिफाई इट? इट हैज दीज टिपिकल एलिप्टिकल स्केल्स. ओके, सो यू हैव टिपिकल एलिप्टिकल स्केल्स इन दिस. एंड वॉट काइंड ऑफ वेनम डू यू हैव इन दिस स्केल, इन दिस स्नेक? अगेन इट इज अ वैस्क्युलो टॉक्सिक वेनम. ऑलराइट, लेट्स मूव ऑन टू आर नेक्स्ट स्नेक. You can look at the environment only and actually identify the snake. It has a very typical environment which will help you in identifying the snake. So identify the snake. What is the identification feature? And also what type of venom does it produce? Okay, so you can see that the snake is in the environment of the sea. Okay, so this is called as a sea snake. It typically is greenish in color, so that is one of the ways of identifying the snake, but it can also be multicolored. Okay, another very typical or specific thing to identify it is the tail. The tail of the snake will be paddle shaped. Okay, and the venom is myotoxic in nature. So this is one of the few snakes in which the venom is myotoxic in nature. The rest were all neurotoxic and vasculotoxic. So the venom in this case is myotoxic in nature. Okay, now sometimes in the exam they will ask you the main differences to identify between poisonous and non-poisonous snakes. Okay, so I'll tell you two important points how to identify between poisonous and non-poisonous snakes. So if you look at the belly scales of the poisonous snakes, they will be complete, full circular, and they will be large. Okay, in non-poisonous snakes you will have incomplete belly scales. If you look at the fangs of the patient, fangs of the snake, we are so used to saying patient all the time that I ended up saying patient. Okay, so if you look at the fangs of the snakes, there are two fangs in poisonous snakes, and there will always be more than two fangs in non-poisonous snakes. Okay, so there are multiple fangs in non-poisonous snakes. All right, so this was about all the snakes. You have very typical identification features in snakes. You can look at the color of the scales, you can look at all these extra things like monocillate, the eye, arrow on the head, taxi color, and you can identify the snakes easily. Okay, now next let's move on to the poisons. So have a look at this poison. Why I have put these two three pictures with it is I want to tell you what does this poison produce. So this poison produces green colored urine, then it produces pigmentation around this perioral area, and it produces hyperpigmentation in cartilage and cornea. Okay, so this is called as ochronosis, pigmentation of the cartilage, cornea and perioral area. Okay, and if you look inside the oral mucosa, then what will you see over here? Inside the oral mucosa you will see that you have brownish oral mucosa. Okay, so which kind of poison causes this? Any idea? I can give you another thing that happens in this. If you look at the stomach also has brownish mucosal color in that, and the stomach is called as leathery mucosa. The brownish colored mucosa of the stomach is called as leathery mucosa. So what poisoning are we talking about over here? Yes, absolutely correct. We are talking about phenol or carbolic acid poisoning. Okay, so in carbolic acid poisoning or phenol poisoning, you will be able to see green colored urine, then brownish oral mucosa and ochronosis. Okay, now one of the frequently asked questions, they will give you this kind of clinical features and ask you what is the metabolites of this poison. So you should know the name of the important metabolites of phenol. So one of them is pyrocatechol and the other one is hydroquinone. Okay, all right. moving on to our next picture. So try to identify this tube and what is the use of this tube. Identify the use of this tube and what is this tube used for. Alright, so this tube is called as your Ewald's tube and it is used for giving, this is your Ewald's tube and the use is for gastric lavage. It is used for giving gastric lavage and removing poisons. Okay, alright. Next picture, try to identify this poison. This is a picture of the stomach, a gross pathological specimen of the stomach after ingestion of this poison. So if you see, if you look at it, it has blackish gastric mucosa. There is blackish gastric mucosa and here I am showing you that the patient is vomiting continuously. Okay, so there is coffee ground vomitus in this case. So if you look at the gastric mucosa, it is blackish in color and there is coffee brown vomitus and these are the crystals of the poison. So what is the poison that you see over here? Any idea? Okay, very good. This is oxalic acid. Okay, so this is oxalic acid. So oxalic acid poisoning, you will see blackish gastric mucosa and coffee ground vomitus in the patient. Okay, now next over here. This is the poison. It is bluish black in color. When you look at the gastric mucosa in this place, okay, just have a quick look at the gastric mucosa. You will see that the gastric mucosa has turned yellowish blue in color. Now this picture, I know it shows it as brownish black, but just imagine, I'll put the color over here. So it is yellowish blue gastric mucosa. Okay, so now remember it, the gastric mucosa turns yellowish blue in color. So what is the poison that you see over here? The poison, which is bluish black in color and it produces yellowish blue gastric mucosa. Absolutely correct. So the poison in this case is iodine. Okay, and how do you treat this? You have to give a gastric lavage, obviously. And with what do you give a gastric lavage? You give gastric lavage with starch or with sodium thiosulfate. Okay, so this is about iodine. Next poison is this. So here what are you seeing? First of all, when you see the gastric mucosa in this case, it is green and leathery gastric mucosa. Next, what can you see over here? You can see the teeth. Okay, so on the teeth you are seeing this greenish line. If you can see it over here, can you see this greenish line on the teeth? Okay, so this greenish line on the teeth is called as your Clapton's line. Clapton's line, okay. And finally, I have drawn this over here. You can see, what is this? This is spraying of insecticides. So this disease is called as your vineyard sprayer lung disease. Vineyard sprayer lung disease. Okay, and where do you see all of these? So when the poison is a part of the insecticides which is used for spraying in vineyards where you grow raisins for wine. Okay, so this poison when ingested produces this Clapton's line and green leathery mucosa of the stomach. So what is this poison? Anyone? Absolutely correct. This is copper poisoning. Okay, this is all seen in copper poisoning. Okay, now next thing that you see over here, next three things, identify the poison over here. Very easy. This poison is frequently discussed in dermatology. Okay, So what are these white transverse lines that you see over here? These are called as Mies lines. Okay, Mies lines, they are white transverse lines on nails. Okay, then what are you seeing over here in the hand? There is a particular type of pigmentation. It looks like raindrops have fallen onto the hand of the person. Okay, so this is also called as raindrop pigmentation. Okay, and this is actually the picture of the poison. So what is this poison? Any idea? Yes, so this poison is nothing but arsenic. Okay, so you see Mies lines, I'll write it over here, arsenic poisoning. So you will see Mies lines on the fingers, on the nails, and raindrop pigmentation on the hand in case of arsenic poisoning. Okay, now next you have this patient over here having excessive salivation, and the patient is coming to you with neuropsychiatric symptoms. Excessive salivation plus neuropsychiatric symptoms. So specifically you will see tremors in this patient. So what is the poison in this case? Yes, so excessive salivation and neuropsychiatric symptoms are also seen in case of arsenic poisoning. Okay, so these are also symptoms of arsenic poisoning. So what all are you seeing in arsenic poisoning? You're seeing Mies lines, you're seeing raindrop pigmentation, you're seeing excessive salivation and neuropsychiatric changes. Okay, now this next picture that you can see over here, this typical Japanese patient when you see, and in the eyes, what are you seeing over here? In the eyes you are seeing mercuria lentis. Okay, and what are you seeing in the hand? You are seeing that the hands and the feet, that is the periphery, is specifically pink in color. Okay, so this is nothing but acrodynia. So this is acrodynia, also means pink extremity. So what are you having over here? You are having mercuria lentis, you are having this mentally retarded state of the patient, you are having acrodynia, then you get membranous colitis in the colon, and along with that you also get all these symptoms together, in which you call it as Mad Hatter's disease. So what is the poison which causes this Mad Hatter's disease? Any idea? Yes, absolutely correct. Your Mad Hatter's disease is caused as a result of mercury poisoning. Okay, so in mercury poisoning you have mentally retarded patients, mercuria lentis, membranous colitis and acrodynia. Okay, now next picture you can see over here, this blackish pigmentation that is present above the upper gums. What is this called? And this patient here is presenting with this typical feature of foot drop. So this pigmentation is specifically called as, this blackish gray line on the gums is called as Bertinian's lines and foot drop. Along with that, the patient also presents with pallor. So he has anemia and he presents with dry belly ache. Okay, what do you mean by dry belly ache? Dry belly means the patient is constipated. Okay, so there is constipation and there is spasm of the stomach. Okay, so dry belly ache, anemia, constipation plus spasm. What is the condition in which you see all of these? And in females you will see amenorrhea. So this is due to chronic poisoning of which heavy metal? You are seeing Bertonian's lines, foot drop, anemia, constipation, and spasm of the stomach. Any idea? Yes, so all of this is seen in lead poisoning. All of this is seen in lead poisoning. Okay. Now, your lead poisoning ka antidote. What is the antidote of lead poisoning? It is BAL. Okay. So, remember this. They ask this in the exam. What is the antidote of lead poisoning? So, it is BAL. Okay. Now, one of the most important questions asked in your exam, they give you pictures of seeds of different plants and they want you to identify the toxin that is produced by the seed. Okay. So, identify this seed. Tell me its name. Tell me the name of the toxin it produces and what does it do? And what is the main identification feature of this seed? Okay, so identification feature mein you can always remember the seed looks like cockroach. Okay, so cockroach looking seed. And if you cut this seed, then the lumen will appear completely circular. Okay, so the lumen is circular. Aisa cut karoge, to lumen will be circular. So, how do you identify cockroach looking seed over here? Brownish black in color. This is your castor seeds. Okay, and what is the name of the toxin in castor seeds? The name of the toxin in castor seeds is ricin. What does ricin do? It goes all the way to every cell and it inhibits protein synthesis. So protein synthesis is required for replication, for DNA formation, RNA formation, enzyme formation. So all of that will be inhibited. So that is how your castor seeds will act. Okay. Now next, identify this seed. What is the main identification feature? And what kind of clinical features are produced due to this seed ka poisoning? And what is the fatal dose? There are only some seeds jiska fatal dose you need to remember. So this is one of them. Obviously you need to know the name of the toxin also. Okay. So these are croton seeds. Okay. These are croton seeds. The name of the toxin over here is crotin. What is the typical identification feature in this case? When you take a cross section of the seed, you will find that it is elliptical. Okay. In castor seeds, your cross section, your lumen was circular. In croton seeds, your cross section will be elliptical in nature. Okay. So when you ingest these seeds, the patient will come with vomiting, watery diarrhea, salivation, and abdominal pain. And what is the fatal dose of this seeds? Four seeds. Okay. Four seeds can produce death. So that is the fatal dose. Okay. Now this one asked many times in the exam, many times. In fact, recent NEET PG exam also they have asked it. Okay. So identify the seed. Tell me the name of the toxin. Tell me the fatal dose. And what is the main clinical feature when this seed is ingested? Okay, so the name of this seed is Abris precatorius. How do you identify it? You can see it is red in color, okay, and it has this black top. What is the name of the toxin? It is Abrin. Fatal dose is 1 to 2 seeds and main clinical features in this case is seizures. And how do you treat these seizures? By giving benzodiazepines. Okay, now identify this next seed. So actually here you don't need to identify the seeds, you need to identify what is growing on the seeds. Okay, that is a good identification feature. Tell me the toxin that is produced by it. What are the clinical features whenever this poisoning happens? Okay, so actually we have to identify the fungus that is growing on the seeds. Okay, so this is nothing but ergot fungus. This is also called as Claviceps purpura. This ergot fungus is also called as Claviceps purpura. The toxin that is produced by this is called as ergotoxin or ergotamine. What are the clinical features in this case? Patient can come with hypertension, he can come with convulsions, he can come with peripheral ischemia, and he can come with hypercoagulability. So multiple formation of clots in different arteries. Okay. And these seeds are also used for inducing abortion in patients. Alright. Next set of seeds over here. Identify them. You all must have eaten these seeds also. Identify and tell me the name of the toxin in this case. So these are called as chili seeds or capsicum seeds, and the name of this toxin is capsicum. Okay, name of the toxin is capsicum. Okay, now identify tell me the name of the toxin. And what is the main identification feature? Okay, so this is called as madar or calotropis. Okay, how will you identify? This has white, this plant has white, purple, whitish purple flowers. And the main toxin produced by it is calotropin or calotoxin. Okay, alright. Last seed to be identified over here, very very important, asked in the exam multiple times. So identify this seed. What is the fatal dose of the seed and what is it specifically used for? So the specific uses of the seed. So this completely blackish brown seeds, as you can see, they are typically blackish brown heart shaped seeds. Okay, heart shaped seeds, blackish brown in color. So this is called as Semicarpus anacardium, Semicarpus anacardium. And they are also called as marking nut. The fatal dose of this is 5 to 8 seeds, and specific uses is it's used for torture. Okay, so actually they used to put it in the external genitalia of females to induce infertility. So this is used for torture. Okay, and it was also put in the cervical os to induce abortion. The next thing, it is also called as the marking nut. So it leaves marks wherever you put it. So it is also used for fabricating bruises. Okay, so that's it with all the different types of toxins that can be asked in toxicology. Semicarpus anacardium, madar, calotropis, chili seeds, ergot fungus, abris precatorius, croton seeds, castor seeds, and then we have your lead poisoning, copper poisoning, mercury poisoning, arsenic poisoning, iodine poisoning, oxalic acid poisoning, phenol poisoning, and then we have all our different types of stings. So I hope that this class was useful to you guys. If you liked it, please don't forget to like the class and join our channel and continue watching it. Thank you so much, and I'll see you next time. Till then, keep studying. Bye bye.